first off, let's understand what pivoting is within Metasploit, or just in general. So let's imagine there's us on our machine with Metasploit, and then within a corporate environment, let's say there are some servers or devices that we're trying to gain access to. Those devices are connected to the network of 192.168.1.1. And then, of course, we have another network, which is the network we can see, which is 192.168.1.5.3. And then in between that is a machine that we'll refer to as proxy. Now, in the real world, this may be somebody's workstation. You may have done a phishing attack or compromised somebody's machine that just happens to be able to see both of those networks. And this is quite common. For example, if you're able to send someone a phishing attack, or they can access a website and download some malicious payload, then they will be able to see both sides, whereas you can't directly see the other side in the network. That machine in the middle is connected to everything. So you as the Metasploit, the attack machine, have direct access to the target. But there's no direct access beyond that, because you have to go through this middle tier. Now, we can utilize this middle box to proxy requests. So if I'm trying to get to one of the servers on the other side, obviously I first need to know that they exist. But once I know this, we can use Metasploit to say, I would like you to do this, and it will go through the middle gateway box, the proxy, and send it off to the other devices that sit behind there. So for example, once we have a meterpreter session to the compromised machine, we can run something called get_local_subnet. And what this will do is this will run on that compromised machine, looking for the local subnets that that local machine has access to. So in reality, what should happen is when we run that command, it should not only just return us the 192.168.1.53, it will return us the 192.168.1.1 as well, because those are the local subnets that exist beyond what we can see. And that's what pivoting is. Pivoting is the ability to go from Metasploit to a compromised machine to something beyond that we don't directly have access to. Now, once we've done that, then of course we can start using other components. And this is where port forwarding comes in. Now, it may sound very straightforward, but in the realms of Metasploit, and in the same scenario that we had before, what we're able to do is in our connected environment, we can forward traffic from the Metasploit machine to those non-visible targets using the box in the middle, using that relay machine. So I'm going to utilize the port 3389 that's remote desktop, and I'm going to say that whenever you see that port, I want you to route that traffic all the way through the relay box, go out to the machines on the other side, and then return the request so the two can meet in the middle. So that means I'm able to remote desktop to a machine that I don't actually have direct access to, as long as I'm port forwarding through the relay machine or the compromised target machine in the middle. And that's done using specific connections and also port forwarding rules, amongst a few other things. Finally, once we have this access all the way through, then really it comes down to token stealing and impersonation. Let's go back through the same scenario again. So we have our machine connected through the relay. Once we have a connection and we can go all the way through, then we can use Metasploit to load a module called Incognito that will look at those machines, or the machine that we wish to get to, and list the current tokens. And these are the user tokens. So domain/administrator, it will have the user token for that one. Once we have that list, we're then able to steal the token, or we're then able to impersonate that user. So I can then go through and impersonate one of the accounts that reside on those machines, which means that my user account that I may be using already, that doesn't really have access to anything, is now impersonating the domain administrator, for example. Now, obviously, that's not that straightforward, but the logic still stands. I'm able to elevate my existing account to be something else so that I can then create an account on the domain. I can give it administration rights, which will give me a permanent backdoor into the infrastructure. So let's get straight to it. We'll use pivoting to run some remote commands. We'll look at port forwarding traffic, and then we'll look at stealing user tokens and impersonating so that we can elevate and be able to create the backdoor accounts. So here we are back on our Linux machine. We're already loaded directly into Metasploit. And the first thing that we need to do is to go and compromise that machine. So what I'm going to do is use exploit, Windows, SMB, and we'll use the PSExec one that we used before. This is going to drop us into the PSExec window. I'm going to set my payload to be Windows Meterpreter session, and we'll do a reverse TCP, which is what we used before. Now, if I do show options, we get all the values that we need to fill in. Luckily, because we're using the same session that we used previously, these values are still set for us. So my R host is the Windows machine that we compromised before. I still have my regular account. And then, of course, I've already set up my listener, which is me on my IP address to SSL. So what I can do from here, I'm just going to clear the screen. I can then simply do exploit. And now we have an exploit open. So we have a Meterpreter session, which is now on my target machine. Now we know that this one works because we used this in the previous module and examples. So I'm now directly connected to this middle Windows machine. So now what I want to do is I want to be able to run specific things and find things that are beyond my reach. So the first thing we're going to have to do is run a command on that machine. So we can use run get local subnets. Now remember where this is running. This is running on the compromised machine. So this then returns me two subnets, one that I know about, and then a second one that I didn't know about. I assumed there was something, but I had not yet received those IP addresses. So now we know that there's a 192.168.1 subnet that resides on the other side of my machine. So now what we're going to do is we're going to use a command called background. What background will do is return me back to a standard Metasploit screen, leaving my session to my machine already open. There we go. So it's backgrounded my session. If I ever want to see the sessions, I can type sessions and I, and it will list me any sessions that I may have active. And as you can see, I have an existing session from before called session 3, but our new one is session 4. So let me just clear that. What we're going to do here is we're going to add a specific route to that subnet that we know we can't see, and we're going to send it down the session that we have. So we created session 4. So this means that any traffic that I wish to get to 192.168.1.something is going to go through my Meterpreter session. So my route's been added. What I'm now able to do is now go back into my session and start to run some commands. So I can do sessions I to make sure it's still 4 and choose number 4. And then I get the interactive session back for number 4. What I can then do is run another tool called run ARP scanner. And I'll specify that IP range that we don't have any information on. All we know is that my target machine that I've compromised has access to that subnet. So let's run the ARP scanner remotely on this machine to tell me what's behind. As you can see, it's finished ARP scanning on that IP address range, and now there's a whole host of machines and servers that reside on the other side. Now I don't have direct access to these machines, but my target machine does. So we can then utilize these machines, we can then utilize my target machine to now get to other machines. And that's the power of what's called pivoting. The idea of me sending packets, traffic, whenever you want to send commands from the attack machine through this middle tier to get to something else. So in our last example, we went through the process of using pivoting, and we were able to run an ARP scanner so that we could find IP addresses that exist on the other side of the target machine that we have compromised. One of those machines that we're going to use is 192.168.1.74, because now we're going to look at how port forwarding works in conjunction with a pivoting effect. So first off, what we need to do is go back and check our sessions. So we can do sessions I, and we'll go back into our session number 4. Now, as soon as we do this, we're now back onto that compromised machine that we already have access to. What I'm going to utilize now is a command called port forward, and I'm going to add a specific rule that says whenever we are listening, so the dash L is the listening for 3389, we want to send port 3389 to the remote host 192.168.1.74. So now we've created a relay connection. So from my machine, I'm actually now able to launch a remote desktop session, and it should funnel it all the way through the Metasploit session to the machine that I don't actually have visibility of. So in order to do this, let's just background the session, because in order to run the tool rdesktop, I'm simply going to type rdesktop 192.168.1.74. And we'll click enter. And this should launch. And there we are. We now have a remote desktop session through a meterpreter session to get to a machine. So of course, if I knew the password, I could then log in, I could connect as another user. But now I have a remote desktop session, I can then do other things with that. And we also know that this machine, by the very fact that we got a remote desktop session, it tells me that it's currently logged in as the domain administrator. So in our last examples, we looked at pivoting by connecting to the compromised machine, having it run an ARP scan attack so we could see the list of machines on the other side of the network. Then we added a route to allow anything for that subnet to go through the Metasploit session. Secondly, we then looked at port forwarding and actually added a forwarding rule for remote desktop, so that I could launch it from my attack machine and have it hop all the way through to the other side. Now, the most important thing outside of that is really elevation and escalation of privileges. So let's go back to our sessions, and we have an active session. So we'll connect to that one session. So we're back at a meterpreter shell, and we can run something called PS. And PS lists services, executables, anything that's running on the machine, but more importantly, if we look down here, it lists out the accounts that those things are running under. So what we can do is actually, what I can do is type get UID, and right now you can see that I'm actually NT authority and system. So I realistically don't have any permissions. But what I could do is I could do steal token, and then I could take the token ID, for example, of this one, 3040, and steal that token. Now, this tells me that I'm now the Konesis Lab administrator. So I now have the ability. Now, obviously, I want to check this so I can do get UID. And you'll see that now I've actually stolen the token of the administrator. So I could perform other things under the guise of that one. Now, what I can also do is I could drop token. And if I now go back and say get UID, I'm now back to my NT authority. So we can flick between the two. So I can say, hey, I'm regular authority. Now I'm administrator. Now I'm back. So we have the ability to go backwards and forwards. Now, one of the tools that Metasploit has built in is actually called Incognito. So I'm going to load that extension, and what this allows me to do is actually do something called list tokens And what this will do is this gives me a list of the delegation tokens and the impersonation tokens that are available. Importantly, you'll see that the administrator is a delegation token that's available. Now, what I'm able to do here is impersonate the token, and I can say Conesius Lab / administrator, and I'm now going to impersonate that specific user. So now, just as we did with the steel tokens, I'm actually now impersonating that specific user account. Now, what I can do at this point is I can go through and run specific commands. I could execute something under the guise of that individual user. So one of the things that we can do is I can go ahead and execute a command, for example. I could launch a command window. So I could choose execute -f. I want to launch a command, so cmd. I'm going to pass some other parameters that we won't talk about in this module. This is then gone ahead to my target machine, brought me back a command line that we've done before. If I use the command who am I, you'll notice that I'm actually the domain administrator logged into that machine. So now I could do a whole bunch of different things. I could delete files, I could add local user accounts, I could do all kinds of different things, or even add users to the domain if I was on a domain controller.